You're live, David Doucet.
Bonjour, monde. It's another happy hour COVID Courtyard concert series with David Doucet and Dee Dee.
And?
My lovely Dee Dee and Butternut.
And Butternut, too.
My co-host.
Yes.
It's great to be here. It's another rainy day, or it's going to be a rainy day in New Orleans. I'm looking out the window. It's dark. And so we survived another week. You know, what can you say? I will say that is a shout out to Mr. George Floyd and his family and what the hell is going on in Minneapolis right now. It's sad. And God, what can you say? I just feel really bad. It sure reminds me of when I was a kid in the 60s and not understanding what was going on television when you'd see stuff like this. So let's hope that maybe we can come up to an amicable resolution. We'll see what happens. Arrests are good. Also, I'd like to shout out to Touro Infirmary, which is our local hospital. It's a block and a half away. Touro is very special to me for lots of reasons, but they sent out a missive this week on Facebook saying that their ER is clean and everything. The hospital is clear. In fact, I have a couple of procedures that I need to have done in the coming weeks. And they said, come and I can go back to cardio rehab. Of course, you have to go through 29 loops before you even get there. But you know, hey, they said it's safe. I'm glad that they survived. And that goes for all the hospitals in the area and of course in the country and the world for that matter that have had to deal with this incredible virus that is just so contagious, and people don't seem to quite grasp that over the past weekend. And so anyway, this goes to all the Touro employees, in particular Suzanne, who was one of my cardio nurses. Suzanne has been awesome. Her posts are a lot of fun to read, trust me. But the one thing she told me when this stuff started was, David,
you don't want to
catch
get
this.
It.
That's what she said. So I got to leave it at that. Once again, a shout out to WWOZ
for virtual live wire.
For posting out that virtual live wire, which has got to be the most amazing thing that we're able to do this. If we didn't have the internet, we didn't have cameras and iPads and stuff like that, none of this would be possible, and you'd have a lot of depressed musicians. It's depressing enough. So it's fun to do that. Also, another shout out, there's lots of shout outs today, to the NCTA, who's having a watch party with me.
Yay!
The NCTA is the National Council for the Traditional Arts. It's in Bethesda, or Silver Spring, Maryland, and they have been responsible for putting on the national folk festivals as well as several other events throughout the country for many, many years. Well, since the 30s. And not going to do dates.
So are you going to play some 30 songs?
Probably.
Maybe?
I always play 30 songs.
There you go.
So they're out there, and unfortunately there is no National Folk Festival this year. I was asked to go, so that got canceled. That's one of the many things that have happened.
But they can have it in our living room.
We can. A virtual.
A virtual folk festival. Yeah.
Why don't y'all consider that? Merlefest is doing that. So. Anyway, thank y'all for listening. I'm going to start off. There's the PayPal information if you need it. It's on the screen somewhere, as well as my Venmo. And this really mysterious Cash App, which is favored by Mardi Gras Indians and some other people in the
locals.
You know, the locals. So I don't even know what that is. So.
But we not. But also, the pet geranium's not here today because it's wet. So. Campari bottle for Becky Smith is standing in. Yeah. It's happy hour.
Have a drink, whatever it is that you drink, fruit juice, Coke, or something heavier.
And hello to Boston. Oh, the Boston Marathon got canceled for the first time in its whole history.
Everything's canceled.
Yeah, except for this.
My feeling is we're going to be staying home a lot longer than we're aware of.
Well, put a happy face on.
So here we go with a nice song that I start off every week with. This is called You Are My Sunshine. It's the state song, Louisiana state song. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Well, the other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, when I dreamt I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. So I hung my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Love you, and I'll make you happy if you will only say the same. But if you leave me to love another, you will regret it some old day. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. I'll play it again. Please don't take my sunshine away. Please don't take my sunshine away. All right. Whew. That was fun. Hadn't played that in a week. Well, I hope everybody's doing well. It's got darker, so I got to give myself some more light here. Woo. Today, we thought one of the themes, I try to have a theme every week. Today we thought about food songs, so it's still clicking in my head, but I have a couple of requests that I need to get through. But first we need a sip of the pink drink.
Pink drink.
There we go. June the 1st is, I think, Monday. Is that correct? Beginning of hurricane season, a very dreaded thing now, for not just here in Louisiana, but the Gulf Coast as well as the Atlantic seaboard, as storms are getting really weird. So I thought I'd try to play an Alex Broussard song that was the title song of my 1999 release, which was called 1957. This song is about Hurricane Audrey that devastated the coast of Louisiana. From my God, almost the whole thing, from Vermilion Bay all the way to Texas, and it was a storm that went sideways, very much like Hurricane Rita in 2005, and destroyed Cameron Parish, Holly Beach, and Lake Charles, and other places. So I haven't decided if I'm gonna finger pick this or flat pick it. I think I'll flat pick it. The song is about the storm, the hurricane, Hurricane Audrey. I was born shortly after this hurricane. And what it did was, it completely destroyed, there was nothing to stop it. Then they talk about the wetlands today, how much we've lost. But just think, in 1957, which was 63 years ago, there was more wetlands, and it still caused so much devastation. Alex Broussard was a songwriter and musician. He lived in Lafayette, or actually Rainer, Doucet. He had a great club called, it was called Alex Broussard Ranch. And lots of famous people played there in the 70s and 80s. And he wrote a few songs. They all have the same progression and the same chord progression, the same notes. So this one was a song about 1957, and this hurricane came and had a huge wave which covered the southern part of the state. And the suffering was immense. All the animals at Grand Chenier were drowned in the marshes. And the inhabitants that lived in a town called Pecan Island everything was ruined by the salty water and so forth. So the first half of the song is all about the destruction. The second half is about the recovery, which was amazing, apparently. He played this song, my understanding was, for the 1958 Brobridge Crawfish Festival in Brobridge. And it played just like Dio Menor's Back Door. When people first heard it, they requested it, and so he ended up playing it several times, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times at the Crawfish Festival. So we have to be proud that Louisianans still, to this day, hang together and help each other out. That's the hope of the song. Dans la neige de Saint-Concept. Et dans la neige de Saint-Concept, dans les mers de la Louisiane. Et dans la mer, y'a mis un lame, qu'a couvert dessus des tailles. Tous les biens des résidents à flotter sur le rivage. On va rappeler de l'ouragan, de dans la mer de 57. Tous les bêtes, la grande chenière, ont été noyés dedans les neiges. Les habitants à Pacagnard ont été ruinés par l'eau salée, et les résidences des îles avec nous, courage du monde, ont retourné de l'eau des îles, de dans les nez de 57. Charité, ça a été donné pour les résidences des mèches. Et le monde camarade avec des lampes dans les yeux. On retourne à camarade dessus l'année de 57. Aujourd'hui, il y a pas Cagnard, les chenières à camarade. C'est un paradis pour les chasseurs, les pêcheurs et les piéteurs. Dans la mèche de la Louisiane, les résidents sont tout contents. On va rappeler de l'ouragan, de dans l'année de 57. For not having any hurricanes this year, for anybody.
But one of the reasons that all the little children died was because it was like July 4th or something?
It was the weekend before. It was July the 30th.
No. July 4th is not the weekend. Wait.
It was the weekend before. Or the week before when it hit. Since I was born on the 6th.
But July 30th is after all that.
June 30th. June. I haven't had that much.
It's the numbers. It's the tell Becky Smith is sending her good wishes so all your numbers.
Hey, Becky, I'm screwing up the numbers as usual. You don't know how hard this is. It's just not easy.
Anyway, a lot of children died because they were on holiday weekend.
If you happen to own my CD, 1957, my buddy Lynn Abbott and I dug up some newspaper photographs of the damage and also of the destruction and the people. There were several people on barges, thousands of people. I'm not quite sure. I should know this. I've forgotten how many people actually died, but it was
a ton.
It was a lot. It was a terrible, 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 terrible.
Okay, all right. So now you've done your hurricane season song.
Oh, you have a request from Jennings, Louisiana.
What's that from Jennings?
Yeah. I think it's Madame Sistine. Oh, and Paquette de Pain. Oh, Jonathan Freilich is here.
Hello, Jonathan.
No kidding.
We can do Paquette de Pain right now.
Cool. All right.
I'm getting ready to do the food songs or foods that are food related or have something to do with food, so.
Roger just tuned in, Roger Mason, so he might know some food songs.
I'm sure Roger does. Paquette de Pain. This is a song that I learned from the listening to the Alan Lomax collection. Alan Lomax and his father, John, came to Louisiana in 1934.
30s.
There you go. And they recorded for the Library of Congress. And there's a website, which I probably should put on here. It's called Lomax 1934. And it's all the discs, I mean, copies, you know, recordings of the discs. Pretty cool stuff. And it was impressive. He came to Louisiana, ended up by Angola. That's where he discovered Huey Ledbetter, but also came in New Orleans. But by the time he got to New Orleans, it was August. And August in New Orleans is not a very good time for music. Still isn't, especially this year, but it's not a good time that everyone leaves. So he wasn't very impressed with New Orleans, and he was looking for I knew Alan Lomax. He was looking for pygmy music. That was his thing his entire life. Pygmy music.
In the West Indies, right?
Well, what pygmy music for him was the origin of all. He was convinced
right.
All music came from one source.
There was one genesis,
so
yeah.
All songs are related. And a couple of instances in our lives.
That's so weird, you might want to stop and think about that.
He tried that a couple of times with us. We were being part of this, and it didn't work out. So. Anyway, he's one of the only guys that bought a Lisa computer, if you're into computers. How do you like that? So
that's a good story.
Which became System 10 for Macintosh.
That's a great story. Sam Beasley's here.
Hello.
Yeah, you're right. So and Gene Chauhan, you're going to play that song. Paquette de Pain.
This is called Paquette de Pain, which is a packet of pins. It's a wedding song. Well, the guy, he asks his girl, will you marry me if I give you a packet of pins? And she says, no. Will you marry me if I give you... you know, a beautiful dog or a cat, depending on the version you hear. And she says, no. Will you marry me if I give you a pretty house? No. Will you marry me if I give you all of my gold and the keys to my heart? Yes. So that's the first verse, the first half, and the second half. It's all, yes, you're going to give me all that stuff. I'm really looking for that gold. Avec toi, je marie pas. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, je te donnerai du bon. Donnerai un petit chevelon. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, avec toi, je marie pas. Avec toi, je marie pas. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, je te donnerai une belle maison. Je donnerai une belle maison. Tout doublé avec ma petite chevelon. Avec toi, je marie pas. Avec toi, je marie pas. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, je te donnerai les clés de mon cœur. Donnerai les clés de mon cœur et mon or et mon argent. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. J'accepterai ta belle maison, accepterai ta belle maison. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, je donnerai un petit chambon, donnerai un petit chambon. Tu doublerais avec ma petite maison. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Si tu voudrais te marier avec moi, je te donnerai les clés de mon corps. Donnerai les clés de mon corps et mon or et mon argent. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien. Avec toi, toi, je marie bien.
For a theme one week.
That's true. There are some money songs.
There's a lot of money songs.
Got lots of themes.
Yeah.
It's fun to say paquet de pain. Y'all all say it with me.
Paquet de pain.
Paquet de pain.
There you go.
It looks like packet of the bingles.
It does look packet of the bingles.
It means a packet of pins.
Right. Marna Bryson just dropped by.
Bonjour, Marna Bryson.
So did Jean Bertrand.
Hello, Jean.
Yeah.
Ma douce amie. It sounded good today, buddy. I heard your version. I'm going to have to do one too now. This is a request from my sister, Paulette. A lot of people in America and the world don't know that my brother Michael and I have a sister. But they know now. She's there. Hello, Paulette. Hope you're feeling all right. How many Louisiana crazies did you see besides Ed Orgeron? In
Pensacola Beach at Memorial Day, right?
This one is a song that Paulette requested last week, and I don't think she spelled it correctly, but I figured out what it was that she wanted to hear. It's not J'adore, it's Je m'endors. I'm sleepy, Je m'endors. This is another of the Lomax songs, might be a little older than, he may have a version of this, it might have been there before, don't really remember. But it's a song that Beausoleil has recorded numerous times in our recording career, and always we try to do a different twist on it. I even put it on my first album. It means I'm sleepy and I'm hungry and I really want to go home, but not the same song that you heard in Jaws when they're on the boat, but that's a drift. You remember that when they're sitting around the table?
Okay, keep talking there. Yeah, they're telling their stories. This is where Little Mary.
Yeah, they're showing all their scars and everything, and I want to go home. That's what this song is.
I don't know
the name of this.
Yeah, it's called I Want to Go.
This is for Rich Siegel. Farewell and adieu.
This is the worst trip I've ever been on.
Yes, we can detract a little bit. Anyway, this song is, I think it comes from around Crowley, Louisiana, and I'm not going to do geography because I love, at the columns when I play live, I always do geography and people just say, yeah. Anyway, Crowley is west of here. It's west of Lafayette. It's over there. And it's a song about a guy who's trying to get home. And he's worried about the highwaymen, you know, the robbers, that they're out there. And I always say that my hometown is Scott, Louisiana, which is just west of Lafayette. And the sign, the motto of the city, was this nice circular sign at the Western, or the Western Auto, just outside of Scott when
Western.
I was a kid.
Western.
Said, where the West begins, and the bottom part says, where good friends meet, and good friends meet. But one of the hurricanes or storms, or the sign rotted off, and it just became where the West begins. So anything west of Scott was known as the Badlands. And so the song is important because the guy is trying to get home and he's not having a very good time of it, but he has a couple of little things to help him out. And one is he has a little jug of whiskey on the saddle horn, but he also has a ferai in his pocket, which is some brass knuckles. So he's looking at some unsavory character. But to do all this and really succeed at it, so he can pass the time, he's thinking about pretty blondes and brunettes. And I'm going to put this in dadgum tuning, otherwise known as dadgab, but I call it dadgum. If that makes any sense to anybody. Yeah. Don't expect it to.
It's been a rough week. Focus is difficult, you know? It's not easy to do.
Yeah, you know, the generalized anxiety is very high
everywhere. Maybe, but you got any, well, you got your whiskey and your little knife. Maybe you can, you're riding westwards. Westward?
A couple of Westward tunes will help.
And there you go. That probably would help, actually.
All right, so here we go. Je m'endors, that's for you, Paulette. C'est bon. Je m'endors, et j'ai soif et j'ai faim. Le soleil couché, je suis loin de la maison. Qu'avez-vous, belle blonde? Qu'avez-vous, belle blonde? Mais c'est tout pour la blonde et pas rien pour la brune. Les gens de Crowley sont toujours dans les chemins, sont toujours dans les chemins, chercher à ma fin. Qu'avez-vous, belle blonde? Qu'avez-vous, belle blonde? Et c'est tout pour la blonde, et pas rien pour la brune. Thank you. avec la jeune de Pombo et la ferraille à ma porte. Sont toujours dans les chemins à chercher à ma femme. Qu'avez-vous, Iberdon? Qu'avez-vous, Iberdon? Mais c'est tout pour la blonde et pas rien pour la blonde. Je m'endors et j'ai soif et j'ai faim. Le soleil est couché, je suis loin de la maison. Qu'avez-vous, belle blanche? Qu'avez-vous, belle blanche? Mais c'est tout pour la blanche et pas rien pour la blanche. Mais c'est tout pour la blanche et pas rien.
Yeah.
Hope you liked it. That's a great song. Well, I get to find a tuning here.
Well, you got whiskey now. You checked your whiskey off the list.
That's right.
So whiskey's food, right?
Yes. Here we go, a food song. Another Waltz, but look at it. This is, I know several food songs or food related songs, and I'm going to play a couple of them. A couple of them in French, one or two in English. This one is one that I've done before. Of course I've done it before, but I mean, to you guys. It's called the Haka Moreau, and this is a version from a guy named Edius Nakamp. And if you've ever heard me talk about Edius, he played some very interesting songs. His parents, or his immediate grandparents, were from France. So he was a little bit different, but he played Cajun music, he played fiddle, sang in French, and he tells stories, like my brother says, about kings and queens and Napoleon and stuff like that, you know? And this is one of his tunes. He adapted a regular waltz, which is called the Hack, or the Little Wagon on Moreau, and he put some new words to it, or elaborated. And it's a song about a guy, a bon bocheur named Moreau. A bon bocheur is a drunkard, happy drunk, and he thinks he's a very good cook. And but he's such a bad cook that he makes even bananas impossible to eat. So the song is about he's dragging this little trailer, this little wagon behind him, and it knocks over in the dust, the poussière, and he gets so excited, he dances around, you know, and everyone thinks he's freaking nuts, which he is. So he does, later on the song, cook a chicken fricassee. And it's not pas mangeable either. It's not able to be eaten. So it always reminds me of a story that I just can't tell anybody. So it's private.
Oh, that's not right.
Well, you know, like I said, if it says on the label of a rice package not to open the lid and stir it while it's cooking, follow the directions.
That's one of your hobby horses.
It's so not
what?
Grits.
So how bad was that chicken fricassee? It was a what? It was called what?
C'est n'est pas mangeable. It wasn't manageable.
Okay, the next time you get hold of a chicken,
c'est pas mangeable.
No, you don't like those chickens. So this is the first food song?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Zillard hack amoros a capote sha capote de la poussia. Les bananes sont pas mangeables. Le candy a tombé. Il était bousselé. Alors donc c'est moro, bien mis pas quand même. Alors donc c'est moro, je l'ai fait cha. Alors donc c'est moro, pour manger des bananes. C'est un gâteur de ménage. On a été chez Moro hier soir. Et nous ont fait un fricassé. Y'a t'es pas mangeable. Yeah. Allons donc chez Moro. Un jour les pays. Allons donc chez Moro. Pour manger des bananes.
That unmanageable fricassee.
So do I.
I think that's great.
It's fun to say too.
All of the Hanson sisters are here. Marna and Rhonda, Sandy. Also the Hawaiians are showing up. Patty is out there. Susan's out there. Keola's got a video conference.
I'm sorry, Keola, because I just played a couple Hawaiian licks. We got George in out there, my friend George Kuo.
With George Kuo.
There's a slack key. If you don't know what slack key is, if you tune your guitar to an open chord, like this is a G, open G chord, and if you know a little bit about music and count the numbers, you can go G, 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 this bar across the fifth fret is C, 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 and if you bar at the seventh fret, that's a D. So slack key really means slacking the keys to tune it to something else. And there was it's like a steel guitar. It's got a certain tuning. And so this is a common tuning in slack key music. It's also just a regular G open G. It's just the Hawaiians call it slack because you slack the keys. It's not in the standard key. So that's really what it is. So it's been a very inspirational for me to listen to people like my friend George Kuo or Ledward Kyle Pana, and of course Gabby Pawini, but my favorite is of course what's his name? Sonny Chillingsworth. And there's so many of them. Ray Kane. One just died, a famous guy,
Willie K.
Died last week, I believe it was. So it's a style and it's a lifestyle of music and how they play. And it's, I can wax poetic for years about that. It's just wonderful stuff.
They're national treasures.
They are. And it's great music. And like I said, very inspirational for me. So
If anybody wants to find out about it, they can get in touch with you, right?
Yeah. You can always, I'll send you to the right place.
There you go. So, aloha, everybody. Mahalo.
Aloha. All right, so I'll play a couple more in French, and then we'll move over to Anglais. I think I got time to do that. My nephew, Matthew, since he was a little kid, always remarked how much I tune a guitar while I play, you know. And I said, Matthew, if it ain't in tune, it ain't right, I can tell you that. And Tuning is not a city in China. All right, so joke of the day.
So what are we doing, food?
Yeah, we're gonna do another couple more foods. This is one that I've been playing. My friend Smith Stickney suggested that I learn this one, as well as a few others, Taylor Smith, and who used to play bass with us, with Al and me, who's now moved to Little Rock, so we never see him. This is a song that we, Beausoleil, recorded. I think it was the L'Amour, La Folie album. I can't remember. We've only done 35 records, so it's kind of hard to remember which song goes on which record. Album, whatever you want to call them. This one is called The Starvation Waltz, and I have been working on it, and it took a long time to figure out because it's not really a guitar song. And I can actually, well, I'm removing my picks. Well, when we recorded it in the studio, it was one of the few times that actually we... It was a one-take song, and everybody was playing on it, and no overdubs, and that was it. That was the final copy, and I just played rhythm guitar. That could have been on Cajunization. I'm not quite sure which album that was on, to tell you the truth, now that I think about it. So this song is about a guy who's out there riding around in his buggy, and I would assume under the auspices of going to visit someone's daughter, and he sees the old man, he's sitting underneath a tree, and he's whittling, and he's and crying about being hungry. And then the second verse, of course, is he's on his buggy, and he's got his grand top, his top hat on, he's very proud of his hat, and he sees the mother, or the wife, she's sitting on the front porch, and she's just telling about all of her misery and crying about being hungry. So it's the opposite of food. It's like not having any food. Look, I don't write them. I just try my best to do them. I do elaborate. Let's see if I can remember how to play this.
Starvation Waltz.
Oh, it's called Les Blues de Crève la Faim. It's fun. I mean, it's a big title. Les Blues de Crève la Faim.
Pour voyager dans les grands bois, pour combattre la misère et pleurer de la crève de faim. passé devant la porte, dans la porte chez ton papa. Ton papa était assis sur un arbre, après j'ai goûté de la misère et pleuré la crève de faim. J'ai passé devant la porte de ta maison. Rentré dans mon bogey, après rouler avec ma grand-tante. J'ai passé devant ta porte chez ta maman. Maman était assise sur la galerie, après la goûter de la misère, et pleurer la crève de faim.
Nobody gets to eat.
Nobody gets to eat in that song.
Nobody gets to eat in that
They're
song.
They're starving. All right. Well, we're going to do a little happier song here. I'm trying to debate
Is
whether...
Is it about food?
Yeah, it's about food. I got two more foods. Two more foods. One in French, one in English. I'm just trying to decide if I want to do the tuning, but I guess I will. Since I talked about Hawaiians and stuff, let's do this. This one is a song that we recorded, Busley's recorded a couple of times. It's called, Food.
Yeah, it's kind of important that everybody knows about Frank Amora's food, too. Since you got a tune.
Another shout out to, about food and stuff.
Yeah, for all of you who've eaten at Bryson's restaurant here in New Orleans or not have eaten here at the restaurant, we have a present for you.
A fantastic restaurant.
We've got news.
So, Frank Bryson, who has a restaurant called Bryson's, B-R-I-G-T-S-E-N, B-R-I-G-T-S-E-N, came out with a cookbook, his first cookbook.
Ever.
A couple of weeks ago, three or four weeks ago. With some seasoning mixes, too. He has those, too.
Ah, that's right.
So this is his spring version. He's going to come out, he said, with a summer version. And I tell you what, if you've never been to Bryson's, if you never heard of it, if you think you don't like to eat, if you, you know, whatever preconceived notions you have, this guy will blow them all away, I promise you.
Awesome. But you can find what they've, Marna set up a little Facebook store or something like that?
They have a website, and it's not written on the back here, but okay. I think it's Bryson's, B-R-I-G-T-S-E-N's restaurant.com. Marna might add it on there for the comments for everyone in the world.
Right, exactly. But because everybody's got to figure out a way to work, even though there's no work, right?
Yes, that's absolutely correct.
So thanks, Lydia and Johnny and Ashley and Philip, Johnny Mathern, everybody. Thanks for coming by to say hi. We're doing food today in French and English?
Yeah, got a couple in English. This is one that I said we recorded a couple of times in my career. And we play it, actually I did on ukulele on the last time we recorded it. And it's called the Chanson de 50 Sous, the 50 Cent song. And if I can get this F sharp going.
Your good friend Danny said, ça va.
OK. Kill Danny.
Hog.
Hello, Danny. When are you going to take us for a flight, man? You get masks and stuff?
We were talking about them just the other day.
We were talking about you yesterday.
Yeah, talking about flying.
Woo, you just never know what's going to happen. Okay, so. Why don't I have that listed right here? This is a song, and I'm going to play the English version after it. It's a song about a guy who, he's on a date, and all he has is 50 cents in his pocket. This comes from a true poem, a real poem that was written at around about the turn of the century. That would be the 19th to the 20th, Becky. And it's a song about a guy, he's out on a date, and all he has is 50 cents in his pocket, and his girl, he asks his date if she's hungry, and she says no. But they go to a little restaurant that has a menu for 15 cents, you know. And instead of not ordering everything, she orders everything off the menu. The French version doesn't go into the drinking that she does, which I'll do after this one. But I kind of put it in this. Speaking of the Hawaiian guitar players, this is Sonny Chillingsworth. I learned a G major 7th tuning, and it's not the easiest thing in the world to play. So there's often a couple of bad notes here.
What if you go with an unmanageable tuning?
It's an unmanageable tuning sometimes.
There you go.
Not like Mauna Loa, but that's another one. Anyway, it's called the Chanson de 50 sous, the 50 cent song. The English version says, if I only had 50 cents. We'll get to that in a minute. C'était une samedi soir. Moi, ma belle, on était au bal. C'était une samedi soir. Revenu le lendemain matin. Lendemain matin au jour. Revenu le lendemain matin. Lendemain matin au jour. J'ai demandé si elle n'avait pas faim. Pour manger quand même. J'ai demandé si elle n'avait pas faim pour manger quelque chose. Elle m'a dit si elle n'avait pas beaucoup faim, mais aurait mangé quand même. Elle m'a dit si elle n'avait pas beaucoup faim, mais aurait mangé quand même. Moi je croyais, j'aurais donné un petit lunch de 15 sous. Mais elle leur a donné un poulet rôti et une demi-douzaine de huîtres. Elle a donné un poulet rôti et une demi-douzaine de huîtres. Moi j'ai mis mon 50 sous dessus le comptoir. Moi j'ai mis mon 50 sous dessus le comptoir. Ma mémé m'a sacré dans un coupier, on m'a tiré dans la fenêtre. M'a sacré dans un coupier, on m'a tiré dans la rue. N'allez jamais dans un restaurant avec un 50 sous dans ta poche. «
good song, yeah.
I didn't get to tell y'all what the last verse was. The last verse is one of the most important verses. Well, what did they do to him? Apparently, in the old days, they didn't make you go wash dishes if you didn't pay your bill. They'd beat the ever-loving hell out of you. So there you go. So the other version that I have, that Ricky Skaggs recorded this. But my favorite version is from a guy that used to play with Doc Watson. His name was Clint Howard. And it's the entire poem that they put it on. It's got both parts, so I'm going to try to do it. I get this thing up in tune real quick. Yeah.
While you're tuning up, Paul Sabor dropped in.
Hello,
out.
Paul.
That's good, yeah.
How is the Milwaukeean?
Exactly. How is the Milwaukeean?
You know, it's terrible that we have to social distance, like, via the internet, which is, it's hard.
So do you think people miss going out to eat more or going to hear music more?
I think they miss going out to eat. But some people miss going out to see music. I think that...
I wonder if we did it. We could do it informal. Hole or whatever.
That's true.
What do you miss the most?
I could have a Google form for that.
You could have a Google form for that. Yes, you could. You absolutely could. Data collection.
It's all about data collection.
I miss going out to eat, I think.
I do too.
So I think I'll get some roast chicken and some oysters, huh? Good. Yeah. Dinner descend this week.
We're gonna try.
Except the chicken could be imagined.
Could be. Alright. So this is the other version of the same song. And sometimes, some shows, there's a couple of Cajun songs that are the same as an American songs. I call them American songs in English. That either the Cajuns picked up on their walk from Boston to South Louisiana.
Maine.
Or Maine, rather. Or, who knows. But the stuff you can say on this, huh? This one is, it's called 50 Cents, If I Only Had 50 Cents. And it's a whole different world, but the ending is exactly the same. So Clint Howard, as I was saying, played music with... Doc, and there was a fiddle player named Fred Price, and the leader of the group for a couple of years before he died was Clarence Ashley, Tom Ashley, who had somehow got this group together, and they toured a little bit till Clarence Ashley got sick, and then Doc toured with Clarence and Clint Howard and Fred, and then Fred died, so they decided not to do it again. But the last time we played at Merle Fest, which was I think 10 years ago, Clint was still alive, and I got to see one of his shows. He was a great guy, and to tell you the truth, there was one of the last Smithsonian Folklife festivals that we played at, which was in the 90s. Tommy Como was with us before he got, you know, his life ended real short, quickly. Clint was there, and Michael and I asked him to play this song or to sing this song, and because he didn't know there was a French version, and I'd never really heard the English version, so here we go. That's not the right one. Why isn't that the right one? Oh, no wonder it says G. It should say D for Doucet. I knew that didn't sound right. Took my girl to the fancy ball, it was a social hop. We stayed all night till the break of daylight, waiting for the music to stop. Into a restaurant we went to buy us all a plate. She said she wasn't hungry, but this is what she ate. Y'all ready? A dozen raw, a plate of slaw, a chicken and a roast. Some applesauce and asparagus and soft shell crabs on toast. A big barbecue, crackers too. Oh, her appetite was immense. When she called for pie, I thought I'd die, for I just had 50 cents. You bet I wasn't hungry. I didn't care to eat. I got some money in my jeans. I know that she's hard to beat.
She said she didn't break the bank. She said she wasn't thirsty. Well, after she told me she wasn't thirsty, this is what she drank. A whiskey skin, a glass of gin, who makes me shake with fear? A ginger pop with rum on top and a schooner full of beer. A glass of ale, a gin cocktail, she should have had more sense. When she called for more, I fell on the floor, for just had 50 cents. I wasn't thirsty, I didn't care to drink, expecting every moment to be kicked out on the street. She said she'd bring her friends around someday and we'd have some fun. So then I showed the man my 50 cents and this is what he done. He tore my clothes, he smashed my nose, he hit me in the jaw. He grabbed me by the collar and he threw me in the hall. He caught me where my pants is loose and threw me through the fence. Now take my advice, don't try it twice if you just got 50 cents. Now take my advice, don't try it twice if you got but 50 cents.
So why do you think she drinks in the English, the American version, but she doesn't drink in the French version? They got tired?
Because in Cajun music, it has to be a dance song.
Right.
And I heard the original, and I think that that either there wasn't enough time left to record
right.
the tune, or they didn't feel like translating it in the
all
French.
All that stuff.
It's a lot of work doing
it
that
is,
translation
yeah.
business.
True enough.
You know, so it's...
But it's such a great song.
It is. It really is. I think I know any other. Well, I probably know some other food songs in English, but they're not coming to me right now.
Well, there's a lot of food in your Woody Guthrie song. It's all about food, but that's the last song.
That's the last song.
Yeah. So we're gonna move to the American side of things, or
we American. I don't know. I know my friend Doug had requested some Martin Bogan and Armstrong, and you know, that's a group, you know, it's a trio with a bass, so that's a quartet. It's very difficult to translate what those guys did. If you've never heard of Martin Bogan and Armstrong, I don't even know if their records are still in print, but their first record was called The Barnyard Dance, and then they were awesome. I still listen to them. I was listening to them this week trying to figure out which song. I know the one Doug wants. He didn't even ask about it, but Maria's coming up. All right, Doug, if you're listening today. And some of them, Yes, Pappy, Yes, is stuff that I used to do when I play with Raul Bro and Ken Kepler and Tom Martino back at the Red Dog days in the late 70s. Well, that don't sound right. Let's get this. I got this slingshot capo that I'm trying. I bought this from a slotted head, and it works pretty good on the OM too.
Richard Pattison is here, all the way from California.
Richard, I'll tune your guitar.
Come home, Richard.
That's not bad. So, believe it or not, I do have some friends in New Orleans, and. Thank you, Leslie, Nash, and Chef Eric, and Tammy, of course, and Tammy's beau, Cato, who requested this song about a month or so ago, and it could have been longer, it could have been during the jazz, but I don't even remember. And so I've been working on it, and you know, we're gonna do it. Whether it works or not, we find out.
But one of the great things was discovering Greg Allman's version, right?
Yes, but we didn't give away all our secrets, but you're absolutely right.
I was doing it for Cato.
It's a Sleepy John Estes song, who actually I'd never, ever listened to. I never had an album of his, and I actually forgot about him and saw photographs of Mississippi John Hurt with him. So it was my own mistake not to go listen to it. So Cato, had suggested I learn this song called The Floating Bridge. And the first time I heard it was, you know, say, I can't do that, man. That is like out of my style. That is like really serious Mississippi Delta blues that, man, you got to have the right rhythm. You got to have the right notes. You got to have the right voice for it. And it's been bothering me for weeks and weeks on end. You know, I listened to it and said, man, that guy's just strumming guitar, but it sounds like there's a whole band playing. There's a guy playing harmonica in the background, and it's a hell of a song. And then somehow it came up to me that, thank you, Doug. Greg Allman.
Puppies.
Greg Allman recorded a version of this with Dr. John on piano playing this. And it's, he has to go say, that's Butternut, y'all.
Yeah, co-host. That's your co-host.
All right, so there we go. I think we're all tuned up now. So the song is called The Floating Bridge. And it what it does, it gives you the free songs. And if you don't know what the free songs are, it's...
chill bumps.
Then you get chill bumps on your, on your arms.
Some people call it chicken skin, but chill bumps is
free songs.
It's a story about drowning.
Or almost a drowning.
Almost a drowning.
Tell me 5 minutes of the water I was in.
the easiest song in the world to play.
It did great. That's been a lot of work. Kato, that was all for you, baby.
Hope you heard it, buddy.
Also, if the rest of you have any requests, English, French, or what else you do?
Well, I'm not in Espanol yet.
But who knows, right?
That's true.
That's true.
Let's see. Let's do something fun. This always reminds me of the old days. I used to play these kind of odd songs that I still like a lot. And this one is, it's a true story about a modern day bandit from the 20s or the 30s in North Carolina. So this is a Doc Watson song called Otto Wood the Bandit. Otto Wood, it's like I said, it's a true story, and it's kind of cool, you know. You know, we had Bonnie and Clyde who got ambushed in Arcata, Louisiana. Is that
Arcadia?
Right? Arcadia, Louisiana. Sorry.
Actually, I think to be accurate, it was just outside Arcadia.
Just outside Arcadia. You know, every state in the Union has an Arcadia. I think that's interesting, but it's not related to Acadia. Anyway,
no, it's related to the Greek thing. The ideal.
It's a Greek thing, that's
right.
Yeah, it's not a Cajun thing. So my lovely wife, Dee Dee's parents, or grandparents, or someone in their family had the funeral home, is that correct?
They had the furniture store, which was also the funeral home, because the furniture store made caskets.
There you go.
Anyway, they plugged up their holes and sent them home.
The song's not about Bonnie and Clyde, though. But
no, it's about bandits, though, right? It's about bandits in the 30s.
Yeah, bandits Otto in the Wood. 30s. So yeah. Otto Wood, and this is apparently a true story from Wilkes County or somewhere up there in North Carolina, about this guy,
well,
Otto.
I don't know anybody.
I don't either. But he had his own way of doing things, and it's just the name was great, Otto Wood. And Doc did this, Clint Howard did it, a lot of people do it. And it's just a nice murder ballad, I guess you'd call it, but it's a story song. Step up, buddies, and listen to my song. I'll sing it to you right, but you might say I'm wrong. A song about a man called Otto Wood. Can't tell you all, but I wish I could. He walked in a pawn shop a rainy day, and then he had a quarrel with the clerk, they say. He pulled out his gun, his truck, and fatal blows. This is the way the story goes. Otto, why didn't you run? Otto's done dead and gone. Otto, why didn't you run when the sheriff pulled out that 44 gun? Well, they spread the news as fast as they could. The sheriff served warrant on Otto Wood. The jury said murder in the second degree, and they put past us to the penitentiary. Well, they put him in the pen, but it done no good, cause it couldn't hold the man they call Otto Wood. Well, it wasn't very long till he slipped outside, pulled the gun on the guards and take me for a ride. Otto, why didn't you run? Otto's done dead and gone. Otto, why did you run when the sheriff pulled out that 44 gun? Well, the second time they caught him was way out west, and a whole up gang he got shot through the breast. Well, they brought him back, and when he got well, they locked him down in the dungeon cell.
He was a man who could not run, cause he always toted the 44 gun. He loved the women and he hated the law, just didn't take nobody's jaw. Otto, why didn't you run? Otto's done dead and gone. Otto, why didn't you run when the sheriff pulled out that 44 gun? His gun, and then he said, if you make a crooked move, you both will fall dead. You better crank up your car and take me out of town. But a few minutes later, he was graveyard bound. Otto, why didn't you run? Otto's done dead and gone. Otto, why didn't you run when the sheriff pulled out that 44 gun? Otto, why didn't you run? Otto's done dead and gone. Otto,
you know, everyone has
he to ran and they shot him, huh?
Everyone has to deal with poor Otto, so yeah. There you go.
Everybody's got a poor Otto, right?
Trust me, everybody got a poor Otto. All right, let's see here.
So bandits, or where we had a cowboys? Is it time for the cowboys?
It's time for a cowboy.
You think it's time for a cowboy? Oh, cowboys.
Which cowboy song would you like, Dee Dee? Which, how about America? What would y'all like? Running Gun, Big Iron on His Hip?
Big Iron on His Hip, man. Danny just threw in Poncho and Lefty, but do you still have the words for all that?
I got all the words, but I have to
practice.
That's
a huge song.
It's a good tune.
Epic. Let's see. What else you got?
Well, we'll do Big Iron, which is kind of like a Gary Cooper type song that I've always admired.
Is this the one that has every number adds up to 21?
Yes.
Okay.
It's the song with all of the numerology.
Numerology, yeah.
This is a Marty Robbins song that he recorded, I think it was 1959. I think he thought this one was going to be the hit, but obviously the flip side of this one was El Paso.
El Paso. So
and tell me, if you've never heard El Paso, maybe you should go woodshed for a while and go listen to some music. But anyway, the not El Paso City, which Marty Robbins also wrote, which from 30,000 feet above the desert floor, I see it there below. The city with a legend, the West Texas city of El Paso, where long ago I heard a song about a Texas cowboy and a girl. Anyway, he
it was, what do you call it? It's a sequel, right?
It is a sequel.
Yeah.
And El Paso is a great song, except that it's hard to sing. And it's a song you don't want to play in a bar. I'll give you a little secret here, because everyone's going to try to sing it, and I guarantee you.
Oh, the noise.
The noise is awful.
When they do the West Texas Wind.
I do have memories of driving back from Jay's Lounge in Cankton, Louisiana, just north of Scott, where I'm from. I'd be with my buddies Doug and Richard, and driving back from Jay's after he'd seen a Cajun band, or maybe even Clifton Chenier, or God only knows what. I don't even remember. But you'd hear the last set of the Grand Ole Opry. Of course, on Saturdays, they had two shows that they'd play on the radio. Start at 8 Central, and the second show started at 10:30 or 11, I can't remember. And you could hear Marty Robbins always wanted to be the last on the show. Not because there was no one listening, it's because everybody was still listening. And they could do these cowboy songs at length. So it was great to listen to, especially when you had a few Pabst Blue Ribbons or whatever we were drinking at the time. I do remember that beer cost 35 cents at Jay's Lounge. That just still blows me away to this day. That was a lot of money then. Anyway, this is a song that he did record, and Al and I play it. It's on that pink record, that wonderful pink record, Gunfighter Ballads and Trail Songs that El Paso's on, and several other Westrum tunes that we love today. And this one is a song that I found. It's a movie and a song, and Gary Cooper would be the lawman, and probably Lee Marvin would be Texas Red, the bad guy. That's how I saw it.
Wait, are you sure Texas Red's the bad guy?
Oh yeah, Texas Red. Oh, okay, he's the bad guy. He's the guy with the numbers. He's got 20 notches on his pistol, but you don't say it like that, Marty. It's a 19 plus 1 and blah, blah, blah. Anyway, I think numbers are important in this song. And for you NCTA people out there, there's one other note about this particular thing, about Marty Robbins. You know, Joe Wilson was the head of the NCTA from, probably the mid-70s, before Andy Wallace was, so after Andy Wallace. And Joe took over, but one of Joe's jobs, I was looking to have one of his books, I have both of his books here. One's an autobiography and the other one is about folk, how to put on a folk festival. And he was Marty Robbins' semi-bodyguard and like manager for a little while of the many jobs that he did. So he had a few stories about Marty Robbins, all of which are unbelievable.
Are they in the book?
No.
Only me
and probably Barry Burgey and Michael and several people.
Okay.
So the younger people at the NCTA, I don't know if they know the stories, but Marty was quite a character. You know, he was from Arizona, man. He did what he wanted to do. Don't they still do that there? Anyway, this one's called Big Iron on His Hip. To the town of Aqua Free, rode a stranger. Hardly spoke to folks around him, he didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. I forgot to mention too, the great guitar player Grady Martin played on this song. He played all those wonderful licks in El Paso. He also had a nice record at a bar that we go to sometimes in New Orleans that had a jukebox until recently. And Grady Martin's Happy Birthday was truly one of the most amazing things. No singing, just playing guitar on. I better get back to the story, y'all. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. Look at this, was a pig gig, I went through this. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came a whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red.
Lee Marvin.
Many men had tried taking, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 to 19 more. 1 to 19 more.
heaven when they walk down in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew that a handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when he stopped to make the play. And the swiftness of that ranger is still talked about today. I got a hair in my mouth. Sorry, y'all.
Cognac time.
Got it. Well, there was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of that ranger is still talked about today. Texas red and not clean leather for a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with that big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered around. There before them lay the body of that outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match that ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron, when he tried to match that ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
You got the cognac?
I'm
fine. Tiello just stopped in after all his meetings, so Hawaii is here.
Hello, Hawaii. Let's see. I did play a John Hurt song last week. I have to do a John Hurt song, I think, Dee Dee. I know.
Which one are you going to pick? Somebody wanted Avalon Blues. How do you feel about that?
That's a hard one. I've been working on that one for about 35 years.
Yeah.
We'll get to it. Maybe next week I might be able to do it.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of... You know, once again, I'll say this for every week. This has been, it's hard having been a musician, a professional musician for as long as I have, and you tend to get used to the songs that you play. So what the quarantine lockdown, whatever you want to call it, has done, it's made all of us reach back into the crypt and dig out songs that we haven't played, that I know that I haven't played since like 1980. And it's been quite an adventure. And remembering those songs has been a lot of fun.
It's like a road show and you're not going anywhere. There you go.
I'll get it someday.
Okay, so Avalon Blues maybe next week.
Right.
Okay.
I was thinking more on the lines of, I did this one on the day that we had really bad internet.
The pixelated day.
The pixelated day.
Yeah.
And I should have just stopped and called it off, but I didn't. So this one is called, it's a Mississippi John Hurt song called The Richland Women Blues. It's famous for at least two lines in there, but you'll hear it when we get there. Mississippi John Hurt was my hero because I learned about him through Doc Watson, of course. There's no way I would have heard of Mississippi John Hurt any other way, probably. And it was great when I got my first album. My brother was living in New Orleans, and he had a friend of his who was working at a store called Leisure Landing. And Pat Berry ran that place. He's still in the music business. He lives in San Francisco now. And Michael brought my first Doc Watson record back and my first Mississippi John Hurt record back. And believe it or not, the B-sides on both of those albums were scratched and not listenable. So a lot of the John Hurt stuff that I first learned and heard were just from side A of the John Hurt Today album. And this song was not on it. It was on the next album, which I got years later.
Did it have two songs?
Yes. Oh, I returned them. Well, trust me, I returned them. But my friend Tom Martino and his wife Martha liked this song. So this is
And this is to Tom?
This is to Tom.
Cool. Who lost his mom this week.
It's called the Richland Women Blues. Give me red lipstick and a bright pack of rouge, a single bob haircut and a shot of good. Hurry down, sweet daddy, come blow your horn. If you're coming too late, sweet mama will be gone. Come along, young man, everything's set right. My husband gonna wait till Saturday night. Hurry down, sweet baby, come blow your horn. If you come too late, sweet mama will be gone. Now I'm ready to go, got red shoes on my feet. My mind is set right for a tin Lizzie seat. Hurry down, sweet daddy, come blow your horn. If you come too late, sweet mama will be gone. The red rooster said, cock-a-doodle-dee-doo. The rich the women say, what do you think? Any do will do. Hurry down, sweet daddy, come blow your horn. If you're coming too late, sweet mama will be gone. With the rosy red garter, pink hose on my feet, turkey red bloomer in a rumble seat. Hurry down, sweet daddy, I come blow your horn. If you come too late, sweet mama will be gone. Now every Sunday morning, just watch me go. My wings sprout out, preacher told me so. Hurry down, sweet daddy, come blow your horn. If you come too late, sweet mama will be gone. First your skirt's cut high, and then now it's cut low. Don't you think I'm a sport? Keep on watching me go. Hurry down, sweet daddy, come blow your horn. If you come too late, sweet mama will be gone.
Great song.
All right.
It's got everything.
It's got lots of stuff. I was thinking My friend Doug suggested Lonesome Valley by John Hurt, so I'm going to work on that one, get the words for next week, I think. I think it's about time for me to waltz on out of here, but I got to play my... I was going to play the Ramblin' Jack Elliott. There's a house in New Orleans, his version, but I think Dee Dee's right. I should probably do the Woody Guthrie song, Pastures of Plenty, which seems to be apropos. We start off with You Are My Sunshine, and we end up with Pastures of Plenty, especially what is going on now, which I said earlier, it's hard to believe that we're reliving this all over again, but it's terrible. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go see the first part of the show. Well, this is hopefully...
So does anybody need the introduction to the Woody Guthrie song? Maybe they don't know what it's about.
I may talk about it. But I was going to pass over one more time. Thanks again to WWOZ, who's been very good about advertising all of these online concerts for everybody.
Right.
I will be also... We'll be here next Friday at usual happy hour time, 5 o'clock. On June the 10th, I'll be live from a place called the Sidebar.
Virtually live.
I'm not quite sure what exactly I'm going to play there, but it'll be just me, unless I bring out a surprise. You never know. We started off the show talking about the heroes at our local hospital, Touro Infirmary, which is around the corner, where my grandmother went to Touro Nursing School probably in about 1919.
After World War
I,
right?
After World War I, and believe it or not, when I first moved to New Orleans in 1984, through Randy Spire and a couple of other sources, we, John Bedrine and I ended up at this apartment building at the corner, and Dee Dee, we were all there,
but better not.
At the corner of Fusher Street and Coliseum, and these two old ladies were downstairs, and the day John and I were moving in, they came, they kind of squinted at you, you know? And they said, "Who's your grandmother?" I think they already knew who the hell I was. And I said, "Lucille LeBlanc from Scott, Louisiana." I said, "Yeah." These were the Bates sisters. They were from New Iberia, and they had lived in the same apartment since 1920. I have no idea. They all went to Touro Nursing School together. So,
which is also in the neighborhood.
It is right around the corner. It is the place where I went to have my my heart attack at, and subsequent everything else. So it's very good to have around. So,
we want to thank them all.
And they have been very good. And this goes out to Suzette, too, who was one of my rehab nurses, cardio rehab. So I can't, you know, I think it's wonderful that they're doing well. And it's safe to go to the hospitals, y'all. They sent out a missive.
Well, they sent out a thank you.
Thank you, Lara, and come back.
Still be careful.
So this song, Pastures of Plenty, is from Woody Guthrie. First time I ever heard it was last year or so. The Tim O'Brien Band played at a club in New Orleans called Chickiwawa. And I went to the show, and Tim's an old friend of mine. He also plays in a group called Hot Rise. And he played this song, and I said, "Man, that's a cool song. The words are awesome." He said, "You know, I played it to the tune of Pretty Polly." And so I thought that was cool. So when I listened to the Woody Guthrie version, I said, "That's not Pretty Polly, it's just Woody Guthrie. He stole some other song." I know he did that, put the music to it, put different words to it, which we do. And so this is kind of like my ending song for these shows. And once again, thank y'all for listening. We appreciate it. If you got it, be kind to the tip bucket, that the addresses are there. Also be kind to all of the charitable organizations that are out there struggling to help everybody. Music Cares, and
Offbeat
Magazine, WWOZ, everybody needs your help, because playing music virtually is okay, but you do miss the sense of having people there, even if there's nobody there. Like being in a venue is nice. So thank y'all. We'll see y'all next week. Here we go. Mighty hard road that my poor hands have hoed. My poor feet have traveled a hot, dusty road. Out of your dust bowl and westward we rolled, and your mountain deserts were hot and your mountains were cold. Pancho and Lefty, I promise.
Thanks, all right? Everybody. Please send in those requests and we'll get back with you next week.
Messy.